بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We are going today to talk about the guideline of enteral feed for premature babies in the Saudi Arabia. This is the guidelines of the enteral feeding for premature infants in the Saudi Arabia. It's come from the Saudi Neonatal Society. This is the member and the reviewer of the guideline from the Saudi Neonatal Society. It's Dr. Saleh Al-Rayan, Dr. Khaled Al-Falah, Dr. Saad Al-Saad, Dr. Yasser Al-Hindi, Dr. May Abu Saud. This is a distinguished speaker all over the kingdom. And there is another international reviewer. It's Dr. Michael Russell and Bridget. Actually, it all come from USA. And this is the first meeting for reviewing the enteral feeding in the kingdom. There is Dr. Yasser Al-Hindi. He's the one the most actually helping me in this presentations. The second meeting, it's come from Cairo, March 2010, reviewing the feeding. So the introduction of enteral feeding, what is the general accepted goal of nutritional management of the very low birth weight infant? So what is our goal for nutritional management? First is to provide sufficient nutrient. Why need to provide sufficient nutrient? To achieve postnatal growth. Postnatal growth approximating that of normal fetus of the same postmenstrual age. What is this means? I need to actually make it the intrauterine equal to extrauterine in sufficient nutrient, and also to achieve the postnatal growth approximately that normal fetus of the same postmenstrual age. It will be same or almost same or similar intrauterine to extrauterine, and also the rate of growth in intrauterine, it will be similar to normal fetus of the same postmenstrual age. This is the aim from the nutritional management of the very low birth weight infant. What is the another goal from this guideline? Actually, there is enteral feeding of very low birth weight infant marked by lack of uniformity. Actually, there is different on debate from unit to unit, even inside the unit, from doctor to doctor, from individual to doctor. He started the feed from the first day. Another one who started within after 2 days. Another one who keep the baby in NPO. So there is lack of uniformity. Our aim or our guideline or Saudi Neonatal guidelines coming from the Saudi Neonatal Society to actually minimize this is debate and the difference of the enteral feeding in the very low birth weight. So the another aim from Saudi Neonatal Society, the Saudi Neonatal Society, is this guideline is come from this guideline is come from the actually consensus on nutritional support utilizing the best available evidence. So this guideline is coming from the standard, from the best available evidence. This is the source of the guideline of the Saudi Neonatal Society. So this is the time to change our practice regarding the enteral feed. And another aim for these guidelines is to minimize the difference in the clinical practice of the feeding very low birth weight infant by having a standard enteral feeding guideline. So the aim and the goal and objectives of these guidelines just to minimize the difference in the clinical practice, especially in the feeding of the very low birth weight infant, and have a standard guideline for the enteral feeding. So this is the first aim from the Saudi Neonatal Society for enteral feeding of the very low birth weight infant. The another goal and objective for enteral feed and the guidelines in combination with early aggressive TBN in the nutrition of very low birth weight infant should fulfill the following objectives. The objective of this guidelines, first, provide nutrient intake that permits the rate of postnatal growth and composition of the weight gain, and our aim to approximate that normal fetus of the same postmenstrual age. This is our aim. It will be similar, the intrauterine to extrauterine. similar in the composition of the nutrition and providing of the nutrition, and similar in the rate of the growth. Same, it will be approximately, it's not same, it will be approximately of the normal fetus of the same post-menstrual age. This is our aim from this guideline. The second issues and the goals and objective ensure that transition from the intrauterine to extrauterine environment occurs with minimal disruption in the nutritional support, and how to minimize this disruption in the nutritional support by utilizing aggressive TPN and internutritional strategy. So how to achieve to minimize the disruption in the nutritional support between the intrauterine to extrauterine, to utilize early aggressive TPN and combination with enteral feed. The third thing, actually, you have to initiate the trophic feeding within first 48 hours of life if clinically stable and advanced to full feed according to guideline. The fourth thing, actually, for the goals and objective of the enteral feed, ensure adequate supplementation, we call it ashes, the vitamins and minerals. When to start the feed, this is coming in the second lecture, but at least you know what is the goals and objective of this guideline. It's coming from the Saudi Neonatal Society to minimize the difference in the units between the individual regarding the feeding. When to start, how to advance. The second issue is you have to minimize the disruption between the intrauterine to extrauterine. It will be sufficient nutrient. It will be similar or approximately same to the postmenstrual age of the rate of the growth. The initiation of the trophic feed should be within 48 hours, and you have and advancing the feed until to reach it to the full feed according to the guidelines. Then ensure adequate supplementations and vitamin and minerals. So this is the goal and introduction of the enteral feed. So we'll come that for next lecture, when to start the feed.